All right, we'd like to welcome you guys back to coverage of the 2016 Vintage Open. We're looking at the Men's Pro Open Final card. We're looking at the back nine out at Pleasant View Disc Golf Course. I'm Justin Myrick, and I'm joined by my good friend Joshua Garcia.
Hello, Justin. We have the back nine starting here on hole 10 out at Pleasant View Disc Golf Park.
At this point in the competition, James Gross had an incredible front nine, got him two strokes in the lead with Jeff Renner right behind him there. Chris Eads is three strokes off the lead, and Kevin Jones is four.
See Chris Eads take the tee box here. He prepares for his drive. It's a flex shot that works its way to the left of the pin. Beautiful upshot.
Tell you, Josh, it's so fun to have tournaments here out at our courses. They really are challenging courses. A lot of times you see the top pros, they can have their struggles as well.
Definitely. After playing this course in the first round with the amateurs, seeing the pros take different shots than you know an amateur would take, yet still struggling just like any amateur would, truly brings a new view to the disc golf.
Eads with a drop-in birdie there. James with a nice safe par. Jeff with his tap-in par. And we'll move on to one of the more challenging holes at Pleasant View, which is hole 11 with the dogwood right.
Yes, the hole goes straight into an open area, then you have to work your way up the hill to the right. It's one of the most challenging holes, I believe, in Russellville. See Chris, ready to make his approach.
And just gets a hold of that tree there, Josh. That's one of the challenging parts of the course, as we were just talking about. You know, sometimes you just, I'll tell you what, you got small gaps out there, and sometimes it's just tough to make those shots. Jeff got himself up there with a good little attempt for a par.
I see James start to attempt to make his approach shot.
Had a tough break off there, kicked him off to the right. Carter had to do some discussing to figure out where his frisbee was laying, but this is where he ended up. Got himself up there. Great shot.
See Jeff Renner tend to make a putt, say approximately 40 to 50 feet out from the basket.
Just missed it. Just got a hole of that basket. Boy, I know Jeff or James would have loved to have had that one.
Chris Eads taking the high road, unlike the rest of the card.
Kevin with a tough putt out of the woods there. And this hole just really was tough for Kevin. He's going to do what a lot of us AMs have done. Many times you step up there and you just don't think about it for a minute and just chains out twice there.
This is a tough hole to make par on. It's a tough hole to get up and down on, and we see the pros struggle with it as well.
Yeah, really. You take a four here, that's what most of the field's going to be taking, so a three is going to play out like a birdie. That's actually one of the true par fours at the courses, and here's where we're going to get to see him on hole 12. Really open it up.
See Chris Eads with a smooth release.
What's always nice when you come out of the woods and you've been playing through the trees, just get out here and just let them go.
Nice
James with a great, great throw.
Jeff Renner getting a little bit of a roller.
And here I think we missed the shot of Kevin throwing off, but you're going to see his frisbee finally come in there. But he just launched it on that hole. It was fun to watch. He's just going to have a tap-in par. Not bad for hole 12. And through Kevin's drive, you guys can see, boy, that's an incredible second shot on hole 12 right here. Very few people are putting like that, right? So he's going to have him a little tap-in par as well.
Yes, Justin, I'm lucky to get a three on this hole.
And Jeff, I tell you what, just hit an incredible par save on that one. Like about a 40-foot putt he just drills. Great putt. All right, coming up to hole 13, where we're going to have some water in play to the right. Let's see how each does. Part of the challenge is the hill where that basket sits. Drops off pretty quick there, so you never know if you throw it past the basket, you just don't know how your lie is. You can easily skip, you know, 50 feet down there.
Yes, this hole is a little bit deceiving. You have a little bend halfway down the fairway as well as some rough to the right.
Kevin's going to give this thing an ace run right here. This was an incredible shot. That's an intimidating putt right there, Josh.
It is. I've seen that putt too many a times.
Chris Eads for birdie. Just drills it. Well, I'll tell you what, that was fun to watch. And I think at that point, this is where Eads, you know, he started off three back. And he really got things going. I think that birdie really, really got him going.
Yes, those putts you see at the top of the pros in the world, and that was a remarkable putt.
Jeff with a nice birdie as well. Kevin now for birdie. Got it. Great bounce back after struggling on 11. Gets a par on 12 and a birdie on 13. Well, that's the thing about the pros, man, that just separates them. They take bogeys, but boy, they bounce back with great disc golf.
Now we see a very intimidating hole at Pleasant View, hole 14. We get to see how the pros are going to approach their drive.
Hole 14, tunnel shot with water on your right. Tough shot here. Eads is going to play it out, as a lot of lefties do. Just take the tunnel out of the picture. Clip some leaves on the tree right there, but he gets through. Josh, the next three up, man, it's just tough. That tunnel just somehow, it tell you what, it pulls those frisbees towards the water. And our next three pros are going to head into the trees towards the water.
Yes, the fairway slopes down to the water, so it's a tough shot for any disc golfer.
Kevin's advantage, he throws so far, he ends up, I think he's going to get up there, and he ends up being safe. These are tough outs right here as Jeff's going to try to do his best to get himself in a position to possibly get a par. Worst case scenario, taking his bogey. Great out, though.
Jeff Renner puts it in the fairway. Have a look for a putt.
Now James is going to look at a similar shot. You guys can see how close that water really is right off the fairway there. So both of these guys went OB. Got himself up there, gonna have a tough four. And he's just gonna go out all around the trees there. And as you can see, he came back great, looking in great shape. Got about a 15 footer for his par putt. And James is just gonna give this thing a run right here. Drills the basket. Boy, we thought in the gallery, we thought that was gonna go in.
Beautiful and clean.
So Jeff and James are both going to take circle fives, while Chris and Kevin both take a par, which I tell you what, getting a three on this old boy, three feels good.
Yes, it does, Justin. And I've seen more fours than threes on this hole, so it is impressive.
Hole 15, you see the basket out there down to the right. Looks like he's going to have about a 25-foot putt for birdie.
James Gross puts it under the basket. Easy tap.
And that previous hole, boy, is really where Eads got himself back in the game. As he was down three strokes on the front nine, and he's really making a move here. Got a birdie putt. And he got it.
Slice it up for a two.
Kevin's going to walk down there. Great drive. Nice little tap-in birdie there. Kevin Jones with a very nice drive, going to set himself up for his second birdie in a row.
James Gross approaches the tee box. See how he's going to drive this hole. Goes to the wide hyzer route.
Skip and a roll, and boy, you just never know what you're going to get on that comeback putt on the other side of those trees. We'll have to wait and see what it looks like. Off the pole for birdie. and have a tap in three. This is what I was talking about, Josh. It's just such a tough comeback putt through the trees. You're not only looking at a 30-plus foot putt, but you're looking at a very accurate one. Makes it through the gap and off the basket.
These trees do affect your putting stance. If you're anywhere near them, they protect the basket really well.
Woo! Great birdie. Kevin Jones. It's tough. He was under the limbs there, so to take the kneel down putt. Great birdie. Hard to see there, but pretty sure he skipped up there right by the basket. Chris Eads did the same. Yeah. About a 12-foot birdie attempt coming up.
Look at that sweet skipper there. Yeah, trying to do what the other guy did.
Just running with the 20 feet out from the basket.
And James, really, just a tough break there. You really want to throw your drive down at the bottom of that hill. Just kind of overcompensated there and caught the fairway a little early. And Kevin Jones with the turkey, three straight birdies. Well, I tell you what, great way to finish by Kevin. Took a tough six on hole 11, but bounced back and finished really strong. That's a scary putt right there. Catches the top of the basket. Trickles down in there. And Eads with a tap in two. And Eads has now earned himself a two-stroke lead. And so really, he's walking in 18. Really probably just wants to get out there. Got a nice little dog leg over, but he's just going to want to get out there in the open. Get a nice approach. Tapping his three for the win. We'll see if he can do it. Needs off the tee.
This hole really is an advantage to the left-handers.
There is a water to your right, and some players choose to take the gap and clear. If you can clear it, you're going to be looking at a 30, 40-foot putt. Kevin Jones did attempt to go for that. We'll see where his landed in a little bit. And that's what you want right there. Get up there with a nice look at the basket. Kevin's trying to figure it out right here. He did, in fact, go into the water, but the question was player advantage. You know, did it come in bounds before it got back in the water? And the card decided, and sure did look like it came in bounds before it went in the water. So he'll be putting for three in the woods. Jeff, a little run at it. Gonna get a par here. Zeed's just gonna lay it up right here. But I tell you what, you have a great drive like that. He's got the lead. He's laid up. Gonna get his drop in three. Kevin out of the woods. Just off the basket. So these guys are going to tap in, and there you have it. Chris Eads, your 2016 Vintage Open Champion. How about that ring, Joshua?
This is a beautiful ring, graciously donated by Jostens here locally in Russellville.
Big shout out to Jossens. Want to thank them so much. And also, thank you to all our business sponsors this year, and certainly want to congratulate all of our 2016 champions. It's been a great tournament. We hope to see everyone back here in 2017. Joshua, thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Justin. I look forward to seeing every one of these players return next year for the Vintage Open 2017.